What's up, everybody? Welcome to Parks' Rant, episode number 30. Today is Wednesday, April 19th, 2017. I know what you're sitting there like, damn, dude, look at this sexy motherfucker with his Justin Bieber hair. They can fling around like some sort of queer bag. Yeah, I got a haircut. Fucking this is what's turning out to be since you guys probably haven't seen it in a while. But whatever, trying to do something with it, getting ready for Vegas because I'm going to dye it and fucking make it all trippy rainbow colors and shit. So you think this is gay? Wait until later, you'll see it. It's going to be fucking ridiculous. Probably in a couple of months. This might be a short podcast because I believe my girlfriend's on her way over. So once she gets here, that's pretty much going to end up wrapping this thing up. You know, so I'll try to give you what I can. I just want to say, well, happy hump day. You know, here we are, halfway through the week. Thank fucking God. It's just another day down out of my way. You know, fuck with all the exercise and shit that I've been doing. I wanted to say, you know, I went to the spin class today because I've been doing that on Wednesdays also. And fuck it, that's got to be the worst class that I have to take. It's so, like, of all the spin classes I take, I go in there 4 days a week. Okay, so I take 3 classes. One day I do it on my own. And then the other two are with one teacher. And then there's Wednesday with this other teacher. And this teacher fucking sucks shit. Radically, I don't, right when I fucking walk in, I'm already like just fucking talking under my breath about this bitch. I can't stand her shit. Just her, the way she fucking acts is ridiculous. That, like, it's, I don't know, there's just something about it I don't fucking like, and it's like just her attitude. That doesn't even include the shit that she does about the class that fucking pisses me off. Like today, you know, I fucking, normally the class starts at 5:30. I show up, you know, it says 5:27 on my phone. I was already running late. I was supposed to be there earlier, but go figure, who knew that you'd have to deal with traffic while fucking walking? I didn't know that was a fucking thing, but yeah, because, you know, the fucking street traffic affects me somehow. So I'm fucking already in a rush. I'm walking, get to this damn stoplight. Like, the light cycles through. It takes for fucking ever, this light. And then it's about to turn green for me to go, and then an ambulance comes through. I'm like, oh, cool. So it fucking has to do its thing, wait for it to fucking pass. And then he fucking goes. And then the problem every time a fucking emergency vehicle goes through a stoplight, it resets the whole freaking cycle. You know, and I was standing on this fucking corner probably for 5 or 6 minutes because the whole thing had to reset, run through the lights before it was finally fucking my turn to go again. I was like, really? Fucking really? God, dude. So I ended up being just like a few minutes later than I wanted to be. I wanted to get there at 5:25, but I got there at like 5:27. So, and I walk up to the classroom and I hear the music going. I'm like, what the fuck? So I look at that, thought maybe, you know, she just turned the music on early, you know, get people kind of hyped up or whatever before they get on the bikes. I go over there. She's already fucking mid-class. I was like, what the fuck? The schedule changed? I checked the schedule on the door, and, like, it's still at 5:30. So I'm like, okay. So I just fucking walk in. I'm just taking my sweet-ass time now. And I was like, okay, well, obviously you started early. And so, you know, she's not like, she's already done with the fucking warm-up routines and everything before I even get on the bike. So I was like, all right, well, I'm not going at your fucking pace anymore, so I'm going to do my pace, and then if I can catch up to the class doing what I got to do, then I'll fucking join in. So that fucking pissed me off. I was like, why are you starting early? You know damn well that people aren't going to get here fucking 10 minutes early, and then you can start it fucking 5 minutes early. No, start it on time, all right? Like, you don't see bus drivers like, eh, fuck it. I decided to take off early, even though I'm not supposed to be at this stop for another 5 minutes. I got here fast. You know, it's time for me to go. No. Because if people think it's going to be there at that fucking time, then do it at that time. Stop changing it out. So that's one thing she fucking pissed me off with. Another thing is, you know, with the other teacher I deal with, not the one today, but the other one, you know, she's got all of her shit set up. She starts on time. She's got everything lined up, what she's going to do, this and that. She, like, motivates the class. Not this chick. This chick tries to motivate, but she sucks. You know, and, like, just her whole teaching style is horrible because, you know, normally they have a playlist on a CD or an iPod or some shit that they have prepped ready to go. So they just plug it in, hit play, and it runs, it cycles through the songs, and then they have their workout in their head of, like, what they're going to do on each song. This chick fucking is sitting there with her iPod, scrolling through, let's start with this song, fucking goes through it, the song ends. She stops fucking pedaling, and then she starts, like, clicking through her thing, so it's fucking quiet for a good, you know, 60 seconds as she's clicking through her fucking iPod, this song. Okay, and then, you know, she'll go, and then she'll be like, all right, come on, let's go, let's keep going. And the fucking, that song stops, and again, and she's like, she'll sit down, stop pedaling, so everyone else, you know, starts, you know, going back to, like, a resting pace, so they're not full blast, you know, because it's supposed to go, like, fucking climb a hill, rest a second, do a sprint, rest a second, you know, just whatever. And, you know, people, she'll sit down, stop pedaling, start clicking through songs, and it's fucking quiet, so other people, they start going back to, like, their cruising pace. And then she's like, no, 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 keep going. We still got 30 seconds on this. It's like, bitch, how the fuck do we know? You're not counting it out. You're not saying what we're doing. You don't follow the fucking song. Normally, it's like while the song is going, that's when you do it. You fucking change the pace of the class per the tempo of the fucking music. You know, if the music starts fucking, like, hard, fast, like, music, like, you want to fucking be up pedaling really hard. If it's, like, softer, but, like, quick, you know, like really fast paced, like dance music and stuff, and you like you're sitting down but you're like spinning as fast as you can. And so, but she doesn't fucking do it. She just starts a drill and stops on whatever the fuck she wants. That's if she ever stops it. She'll sit there and take her break, she'll stop pedaling, drink the water, and fucking, you know, flip through her songs, and then she'll be like, oh no, everybody gotta keep going, keep pedaling, everyone stand up, there's no breaks, you can't take a break, you have to get through this. I'm like, bitch, you're not even doing the fucking workout. What do you mean we can't take a break? You're not fucking teaching the class very well. You're supposed to lead by example, not lead by being a fucking lazy ass, you stupid fucking dumbass. Jesus, fucking irritating. I don't like her style. The other chick I fucking like, the one I deal with on Sundays and Mondays, she fucking kicks ass. She fucking has got everything on point. She's always smiling. She's like, you know, if you can't do it at this pace, drop it down to this pace or this gear and then try to keep up at the same RPMs or whatever. She, like, gives you, like, what you should be doing if you can't do it at that intensity, you know, and, like, she's, like, fucking always smiling and happy. This chick, she's like, come on, let's fucking go. Let's do it. You know, and her freaking, like, the chick's fucking voice is annoying, too. It's super annoying because she's always, like, she has a headset on while she's doing it, you know, and so her voice comes out the speakers with the music, and she's always sitting there, like, just, like, yelling into it, come on, let's go, like, screaming at the top of her lungs. I'm like, dude, I can hear your voice over the fucking speakers, and you're already, like, why are you yelling? It's a small room. You know, you have a fucking headset on, so you don't need to yell in the goddamn headset and then blow us out because you got a super annoying, high-pitched fucking voice. And you always go, woo! Like fucking Bender on Futurama. You ever see the episode where he fucking ended up getting turned into a human for whatever reason? I don't know if it was like the what-if machine or something, but he ended up being showing what it's like to be human. And then he got all fucking fat and drank alcohol and got drunk and all that shit. And then he died and, like, the air from his fat folds fucking, like, every time they moved him, they're like, I just heard him say woo. He's like, no, that was the air escaping from his fat. Watch, woo. She does that shit all the time, but it's super high-pitched. It's fucking hella annoying, dude. I can't deal with that shit. Fucking, what else does she do? I got, like, a whole list of shit. She, like, today, like, this is just fucking me just being picky now. Just me being irritated at just people's, like, thought process. She's inside of a room with no windows, on a fucking spin bike with the lights off, pedaling her ass off, sweating, you know, when she was actually doing the class, and she's wearing a visor. I'm like, why are you fucking wearing a hat? You're in spin class. That thing's gonna get fucking drenched with sweat if you're actually working out, and, like, it's not your, like, why wear a visor? Indoors, especially. Now, I get if you have, like, a fucking hairdo, your hair's all done up, and you're outside, and you want, like, something to shield your face from the sun, but you want to, like, show your hair off, I get that. That's why most people wear a visor. Now, I see people wearing hats at the gym, which I think is kind of dumb. But it's usually probably because their hair's all fucked up and they don't want any of the fucking hot chicks to see it, so they throw on a hat and then go lift or go do their cardio. But you're covering your hair. So it's like, what's the point of a fucking visor indoors? There's no point in it. You're just like, that's just like a fucking, it seems like a dildo, like, fashion statement. Like, that some asshole would put out. It's like, look, I got a visor and my hair's in a ponytail because I work out and I want everybody to know that I work out. And then even though I'm probably in my 50s, I still look good. Bitch, shut up. I think it's just a fucking dildo move and you're trying to prove a point. You know, that was, like I said, that was just something I was fucking just picky about, you know. Like, and also, I think she pushes the class too hard. You know? There's some points where she will tell us to fucking crank the gears up on the bike almost to the fucking maximum. And I'm a big dude, you know? And I'm going harder than everybody else in that fucking class, I guarantee it, including the instructor. And so when she's like, fucking put it up to this gear, I'm still cranking it faster than everybody else. That's like, it's almost maxed out and I'm having a hard fucking time. And then she's like, come on, everybody, pick up the pace. I'm like, bitch, you're not going as fast as me and you're not going as fast as half the people in here and you're only doing half the fucking climb, so shut up. And then you're pushing these fucking people, like telling them they have to fucking do it, that they can't take a break. And a lot of these people are like women. So the women are in there, it's like, dude, when the bike is maxed out like that, they just don't have the fucking leg power to push it. Even if they had the fucking leg power, it's like, if you're only pushing down, like, your body weight can only do so much. If you don't have the leg power, then it's your body weight. If you don't have the fucking body weight, you just can't do it. And some of these freaking women are small. The other ones are fucking ginormous, but, you know. And it's just like, I see something like this old lady was in the other day. She's got to be in her 70s. I'm surprised she's still doing it. She's just like, like just fucking, fucking cotton swab hairdo and everything. Just tiny because her fucking spine has collapsed so far throughout the years. After all the wear and tear it's probably had from fucking riding on horse and buggy back in the fucking 60s. Or not the 60s, the 30s. What the fuck am I thinking of the 60s? All that tick-a-doo, 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 over the fucking years. Just going and just like... Oh, shit, she's here. Hi. And then your fucking... Her spine has just collapsed over the years from all that crap shit. And she's in there just struggling her ass off. I'm recording. I'll be done in a little bit. As soon as I get through all this stuff. How long have you been standing out there? Not very... You just walked in? Were you scared to talk? I thought the freaking neighbor's dogs, I think, are running around out there. Those fucking stupid small ones. And they have the, I can hear, like, the collars jingling. I didn't know if that was you just standing out there, like, holding your keys, like, fuck, he's doing this. I don't want to stand out here the whole time. But now it's just our fucking dogs running around. Yeah, but, like, so this chick, she's, like, pushing him way too hard. You know, and this old lady's going for it, so I was surprised she was doing it. But it's like, she can only do so much. And part of me, just, like, the way she talks to the people after the class, she hasn't said shit to me anytime I've taken that class. But the way she talks to people, she just seems like one of those fucking, I live in a rich area, go fuck yourself, two-faced kind of people. Like, one of those people that'll fucking be all like, oh, how are you? And then as soon as you walk away, that fucking piece of shit, I'm not dealing with them. Fuck him. They can go to hell. She didn't go to Yale. And you see that shirt? Ugh. Ucky, yucky. You having trouble? She doesn't want to make any noise. She's just sitting there giving me the fucking head yes, no. She doesn't want to be heard. In case, like, someone in her fucking family finds this in 10 years and goes, God, she was dating that asshole. We never knew. Or all of her doctor friends. She doesn't want to be seen with me in public. It's one of those things. I get it. I see how it is. You don't want the whole world to know that you're dating some fucking over-the-top ass monkey with gay hair. You fucking nod your head. She was agreeing with me on that. What the fuck? Speaking of chicks, I was walking home today, and I'm crossing the street, and I see on the other side of the street, walking parallel to me, there's this chick walking along that's all dolled up. She's freaking dressed all super hot, and she was wearing this super short skirt, you know, and she's walking by herself carrying a large pizza. I see that, I'm like... there's so many questions. I'm like, where are you going? You know, why the fuck are you out here dolled up like you're fucking going to prom or some shit, or you're going out to the clubs in the middle of the fucking day, the sun's still out, and you're carrying a large pizza alone? Like, what are your plans? Are you going to go home and have like a fat girl fashion show? Like, I got down to my sexy weight. Now it's time for pizza. Like, what are you doing? Filming some, like, fucking outdoor fucking porn situation behind a building underneath a bridge or something? It's going to be some fucking weird new fetish outdoor fucking building backdoor porn food? I don't know. Just something fucking weird, some new weird-ass genre. Who knows what the fuck is this stuff that's out there these days? Like, some of the fucking porn crap that I've heard about, I'm like, really? That's a thing? Really? Like, these weird fetishes. I think I talked about it before. There's a fetish out there, there's a fetish group for people who get off on the sound of balloons popping. Like, I don't get that one. That one doesn't make any sense to me. Like, I get how other fetishes are formed, you know? I think I talked about it before, you know, if people get a foot fetish, maybe like they had some fucking girl underneath the table jerking them off with her feet, you know, at Thanksgiving dinner. And so, like, you fucking the first time you busted a nut when you're 16, it was in your pants fucking right above your turkey leg. Fucking, you think you're like, thank God I got my napkin in my lap. You're getting fucking jerked off by the girl across the freaking table. She's got her feet in your pants, she's fucking digging in there, and you guys are saying grace as you're dumping one right in your fucking drawers. Oh, man! Pass the stuffing. That'd be fucking disgusting. It's fucking unloading in your shorts at fucking Thanksgiving dinner. That's fucking gross. Ah. Fucking who knows. Something else I've kind of been noticed lately when I'm walking around. I don't know if this is going to get worse later as I get older, but my fucking ankle clicks so bad when I walk. Every step, it's just like... Like, what the fuck? It's seriously, if I walk fast enough, it sounds like a cold diesel engine trying to warm up. It's like, fucking hey, dude. Like, what the fuck? It's like a cement truck in there. Same with my shoulders. You don't get a clicking noise out of those. But, like, if you just feel it, it feels like a fucking cement truck just spinning around in all my joints. I don't know. I have a feeling, like, I'm going to be a horrible cripple when I get older. I should probably start including fucking milk into my diet here just to keep shit going. Whatever could fucking help build, like, cartilage back up without getting fucking stem cell shots. What's the, you know, if I ever make the money, I'll probably do that. It's no big deal. But yeah, so, who knows what the future will hold. Speaking of the future, you know what tomorrow is? Thursday. You know what else that is tomorrow? 420, motherfuckers. All you stoners out there are probably going to have a blast. You guys doing anything fun? You got any awesome plans? Gonna go home, fucking pack a bowl on the big 4-foot gravity bong? Yeah, you're gonna fucking get lit up and fucking wreck your house. Is that what you guys are gonna do? You're gonna fucking maybe go out for an adventure out in the woods? Blast it off your ass? Gonna call and work the next day because you're still too fucking high to remember where you are because the sun's coming up and you don't remember these footprints? Because you're lost out in the fucking wilderness? Or are you guys going to be like me? Fucking tomorrow's gym day. Racquetball, that's it. Nothing special. You know, I haven't really just gotten high for fun in a long time. I mean, you know, I smoke at the end of every day when I'm home. Like, right now, I am fucking pretty trash compared to my normal. just because I had to pack some fresh stuff. Normally it'll last me like 4 or 5 days on a single bowl or whatever, because I don't need much. Just use it for medical purposes, so I don't want to get fucking completely hammered. But when you pack a fresh bowl, you know, just that crispy top layer, right when the flame touches it, it gives you a little bit of extra boost. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm feeling relaxed, thank God, because I've just been fucking tired and hungry and sore as fuck lately. So that shit really does help. It just like fucking just lets everything loosen up at the end of the day. It's so nice. You guys gonna do any freaking awesome fucking eating plans? You guys gonna go out and get high? Let's see, what you guys gonna do? Start with some of these? Start with some special brownies, huh? Is that how you're gonna get high? You gonna take a big old hit of weed, or are you gonna eat the brownies? Maybe some cookies, maybe you're gonna sprinkle some of that shit on a pizza for some fucking reason and bake it yourself. It's not delivery, motherfucker. It is Dijon. Oh, fuck, I got high. That would be awesome. Fucking weed pizza. So what we're going to do, then you're going to whip out some other fucking snacks like I got lying around my house that I can't fucking have, like these bad boys. Yeah, fucking macadamia nuts. Those things are fucking sweet. I'm just trying to give you guys ideas for tomorrow. Or if you're watching this tomorrow and it's 4:20 and you're watching this right now, you're like, God damn, I need to go get me some of those. You're going to have the munchies. You're going to wonder, what the hell could I possibly be doing on 4:20 besides watching Parks rant about shit that's funny as fuck, and he's giving me advice for munchies. Now that's a good day. That's a good day. I should have said that at the beginning. It's like, hey, if you're watching this now, fucking just wait till you're getting high at the end of 4:20. This is the day to do it. Look at this. I'm giving you guys a great recommendation. What else we got here? These things? I don't know what the fuck these things are. These are some fucking, like, powdered milk cookies that my girlfriend gave me, which are fucking delicious. I can't touch any of this shit, obviously. I'm just giving you guys ideas. Because that's why I'm here. To make your day better. How about this? Leftover. I know they're done selling these motherfuckers, but guess what? Top sealed. They got me some Thin Mints. Oh, man. These things are going to be delicious when I get around to them. Fucking who knows. You know? Start off with the brownies. Go munch through all that shit. Maybe pack a bowl and munch all that shit. And then end with brownies. Obviously, you're not going to want to end with the fucking weed brownies because then you'll be way too high. Start with these brownies. End with these brownies. You see this? This shit is in my house when I'm trying to fucking diet. At least you bastards can fucking eat it unless you're getting all motivated by my diet like my girlfriend. Or not my girlfriend. More like my fucking sister. If she, like, cause she's doing it, so she's probably sitting here watching this right now, like, ah, you motherfucker, I'll stab you right in your goddamn taint. Just rubbing this shit in my face like it gets done to you, you bastard. I understand the pain. Can't have any of that crap. Not until my cheat day. If I meet my goal, which I'm fucking pretty on par for it so far. So, but we'll see how it goes. And if I get... If I'm further ahead than I planned on being, I'm not going to do my cheat day on the 7th. I'm going to do it on the 30th, so a week from this coming Sunday is when I'll do it. And I'm going to fucking... I'm probably not going to eat any of that sugary shit, none of that crap. I'm going to still kind of try to keep it clean. Kind of. Not really. You know, start off with like a bowl of cereal. Just a bowl of cereal. Some good cereal. Then in the middle of the day, go a little bit more reckless, have some barbecue, some protein, you know, after I get done working out. Still going to do my workouts, not going to cheat that far. Got to keep it going. And then probably by the end of the day, I'm just going to fucking stuff my face with Taco Bell. I'm going to have the fucking, you know, spicy fucking ground beef powder farts in the morning. They're going to be ridiculous. So I wake up Monday morning, just like, bop, bop, bop. Fucking unloading. And, you know, I think I'm going to document it on Snapchat. You know, if you guys follow me on Snapchat, you can kind of see what I do some of the time. My weird shenanigans. I haven't really been doing too much of my working out. I might do it, like, a little bit later. We'll see. But, you know, follow me on Snapchat. It's Parks Plant, all one word. P-A-R-K-S-P-L-A-N-T. Follow me on there, and I'll probably document everything that I do on my cheat day just to show you, even though it's like I am cheating... I'm going to like show you how much I'm going to cheat, how much I'm going to stuff my fucking face to finally feel full for once, and then also show you what exercise and stuff that I'm still doing. You know, I'll be going for my walk. I'll be lifting weights, probably doing arm day because it's Sunday. Be doing the spin class after that. And then probably walking again in the afternoon. Doing my laundry. Try to record another podcast for you guys. And then, yeah, I'll try to document just everything I do. Show you all the fucking horrible food I eat and how I feel. And then maybe tell you guys that next morning. Like, it's like, dude, this is what all this shitty fucking food did to me. I feel great or I feel like shit. Who knows? Because, you know, I'm just fucking out of energy all the time right now. I'm fucking, it's to a point. It was yesterday and today I was getting down to, it's like when I stand up at the end of the day after I'm just, all my fucking fuel is just burned off. Like, sitting like this to going to a stand gets me fucking lightheaded and dizzy. And I'm like, oh man, that is not good. In the morning I wake up, I just feel tired. Like I never even went to sleep. But I can kind of, like, after I get some food in me and, like, get kind of going, I'm, like, still tired. But after a cup of coffee, I kind of start turning the engine over and getting shit going. But by the end of the day, it's just fucking, all that little boost is gone. Gonorrhea, that shit is no more. All right, guys. I'm going to end it right there. It's 26 minutes, a little bit shorter than normal. But typically, you know, I like to stop at 30 minutes, and I always end up going fucking over. So I'm going to stop this one a little bit early. So shove it up your ass, because I don't give a fuck right now, you bastards. I'm going to give you this little piece of information that came to my head. Remember, any problems you ever have in life, they can all pretty much be solved by weed and alcohol. All of them. At least temporarily. Don't go overboard with that shit. Alrighty, I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good rest of the week, titties.